modern technology has grown a lot over the past years. Kids these days know how they are dependent on modern technology, and everything they do now is automated. They don't see it upfront, but everything on the back end is automated. In the next 10 years, I believe everything will be automated, and Idaho Forest Group is the future of automation.
One of the great stats that we have is in the inland northwest, I think it was the 1970s, there was roughly 800 or 900 lumber mills, and they produced X volume. And now, fast forward to today, there's less than 20, but we're still producing the same amount of volume, if not more.
We're changing the paradigm of how we manufacture lumber products. It already is highly autonomous, but in the future, it'll be to the point where you wouldn't be able to tell the difference between walking through a very highly autonomous automotive manufacturer and how we produce lumber.
Taking all those computer science classes at the University of Idaho really set me up to get this position at Idaho Forest Group. I was working with automation team, and I worked on optimization project. In that project where I had to build web application, which will be compatible for both mobile and laptops, which will help operators to schedule the rate of production and monitor the downtime. Idaho Forest Group is large enough, even an hour of downtime will cost them thousands of dollars.
Without automation, we couldn't make it run. It drops our saws, it sends a piece of lumber this way versus that way. We're scanning a log and understanding several thousand data points, like 20,000 data points around the exterior of a log, understanding what's in it. We don't cut the log just to cut the log, we want to make value out of it, so every little percent counts. What you're doing is you're optimizing your process to get the best outcome.
It takes a lot of manpower to run the mills that Idaho Forest Group has because they need to be continuously looked over. They have programmers, mechanical engineers, electrical engineers who continuously maintain and test those big machines. Those machines don't operate by themselves. Those machines need to be told to do certain job at certain time and need to act differently in certain situations.
A lot more computer science and programming is needed. And when you have that, you get these fresh minds coming out of the University of Idaho, coming to IFG with those skill sets. They are very malleable. These individuals want to learn, want to grow, which brings new opportunities for us as well. Whether it be aerospace, automotive, or lumber, our practices are all one and the same. How we manufacture our product might be different, but the skill sets that are necessary for that manufacturing are all one and the same. We design, we implement, we engineer.